dressing table, which basically shows the prophecy of Malachi, the third chapter, 23. So what is written there? In Hebrew, הנה אנוכי שולח לכם את אליה הנביא, לפני בו יום השם, הגדול והנורא. In English, לא, I will send the prophet Elijah to you before the coming of the awesome, fearful day of the Lord. No. Speaking about fearful day, we have now Iran, we have the situation. Now, the continuation of this verse is the following. So what Elijah will do, וישיב לב אבות על בנים ולב בנים על אבותם, ונבוא ויקטי את הארץ חרם. Now, even more frightening. He shall reconcile parents with children and children with their parents. I mean, definitely going in the ways of the Torah. So that when I come, I don't strike the whole land with utter destruction. No, utter destruction today. Very relevant, you have Iran, you know. Almost the bomb is ready. So altogether, really frightening thing, telling us, okay, you should recognize weapons with children, and children with their parents, so that when I come, I don't strike the whole land with utter destruction. But I will send prophet Elijah to you before the coming of the awesome, fearful day of the Lord. So, what we see here, basically, Elijah, we know he's supposed to come and to announce about Messiah, and he will bring people to repent. This is what is written, yeah? Amazingly, what you are going to see now clearly fits with the prophet Malachi, the prophet that we saw just now. So what you have here, I think that the basis finding of it is Ki Lashem Hamlucha, very famous site, that the kingdom is to God, but many, many more verses than I found here. So what they found, Eliyahu Yivaser, Elijah will announce the Messiah, Mashiach. Elijah will announce the Mashiach, amazing. Elijah and Messiah coming in together, and Elijah will announce the coming. Then I looked into it, and I found exactly what the prophet Malachi says. Eshib levavot al banim, he will return. It means he will bring them to return to God, children and parents. Exactly comes minimal in the Torah. With tshuva, with repentance. So Eliyahu will come and announce about Messiah, but with tshuva, unbelievable, with tshuva. Here is the word ketz, because all this to do with the end of days. Ketz is expression for end of days. It also come. The most interesting in this table is the location. Bashana ashvi'it. On the seventh year, Tishbetu, Shabbat Shabbaton, like a rest year, Yel Haaretz will be to the land, Shabbat Lashem, Sabbath to God. Sadcha lo tizra, you are not allowed to sow in your field. Karmecha lo tizmor, you are not allowed to prune your vineyard, and so on, exactly sabbatical year. When we are now, and not only this, even you have the date, A 5000, Taf Shin 700, Pebet 82. So amazingly, exactly this year, coming with a verse in the Torah about it, and clearly indicate to this what we saw in the prophecy. Then, what more we have here, which is very important, you have Son of Jesse, by the way, yeah, the Messiah. You have, right in the bottom, a verse which says the following, Vaya להניח השם אלוקיך עליך מכל ליבך מסביב אין גוד, will give you rest from your enemies. בארץ אשר השם אלוקיך, and then which God gives you inheritance, תמחה זכר עמלק, wipe out, eliminate the memory of the Amalekites under the heavens, don't forget. So what it mean? How can you wipe out? There is a Amalek in each man, in his heart, the evil inclination. This is Amalek. This is the evil inclination, the Satan. And this one we have to eliminate, and then we live with the outside. Because once we don't eliminate the Amalek, then Amalek comes. If you carry on desert life in the Shabbos, the Torah tells us, then Jews desecrate the Shabbos by Abba Amalek. So transgressing the Torah, desecrating the Shabbos, homosexuality, which is also written about Amalek, Asher Kocha Baderach, it defiled you in this way. So how can you eliminate, wipe out Amalek? So only by doing Shuvah, only be Shuvah, that proper Shuvah, not like people saying, I keep this one, it's okay, no. Shamor et kol divrei Torah. Keep all the verses of the Torah, not like reform, take what suits you, but don't do that. No, shamor et kol divrei Torah. Keep all the verses, et hachukim, the status, the commandments to do them. So amazing table. As I said, very significant. I said many times that this is a program that I'm using is Dr. Rotenberg himself came from Russia, like Professor Rips. And Professor Rips showed him this phenomenon of the codes. Immediately he checked it and he said, no, this Torah from heaven. He became a religious Jew. He kept Shabbos, everything fully. Even wrote a book about the codes, all his truths in English. And he said, if it is minimal, if it is best mingin, if it is parallel, is this, you have a minimal, a bit shuvah. Yeah, minimal is also a bit shuvah, bit shuvah, yeah. And this meeting with Eliza, who announced the Messiah, right? So, no doubt, and the location of the Torah, which is exactly about the sabbatical year, you are not allowed to work on the field like today is. And then coming 5,000, full day, 5,700 also. So all together, having this one, no doubt, clear indication and message for heaven. You want Elijah to come and to announce you for Messiah and to be saved from terrible disaster. There is one way, bitshuvah, repentance, and element your Amalek in your heart. And only then will have Messiah peace, tranquility, happiness, and joy in Israel, in the whole world.